be playing Mr. Krabs on Ketamine. So we're gonna go over here. Whoa! Shit, nah, I'm just kidding. So we're gonna beat this motherfucking game and see what this game has in store for us today. So first order of business, we are gonna grab some ketamine. And then we're gonna drive our boat. Hopefully it won't glitch the fuck out. Now this boat is a bitch to drive, so we're just gonna drive it straight over to this canyon area and we're gonna collect more ketamine. I don't know why the camera zooms the fuck out like that, but trust me, this is a very jank game. Oh yeah, you'll be seeing a lot of that action. Yeah, because that's how you play this game. You just, you know, play like first-person shooter and just hit space a lot. So yeah, I'm getting attacked by Plankton's minions. It's fucking terrible. Get to jump on these platforms, which are this is pretty much a challenge. This is the only challenging part of this game. It's hard to believe. And this guy having a fucking aneurysm. Yeah, I just said, what the fuck? Go fuck yourself. Yeah. This platforming section is kind of hard. So as you can see, we're getting some behind the scenes action from me playing this game. It's pretty intense. We finally got the ketamine, and now we gotta go over to SpongeBob, our first mission giver. So what you wanna essentially do is grab as much ketamine before meeting SpongeBob, because he's gonna ask a very specific number of ketamine. And you wanna make sure you're not just wandering around when you start the mission, because you want this to flow like fucking long, luscious dragon hair. So yeah, we're just gonna drift our way over to Spongy's house. Yeah, this is very much the game.
Mr. Krabs, I need you to get my ketamine. It's in town over there, please, Mr. Krabs, I'm fiending. Thank you so much, Mr. Krabs. Oh, you're a lifesaver. If you want to go get more good stuff, go see Patrick. He's on the other end.
What the fuck happened to Patrick? Jesus Christ. So we're gonna be tapping space a lot more, frantically. And now we're just gonna just make our way over to Mr. Krabs. Yeah, there's the fucking car. Alright, yeah, we're just gonna drive over to the lighthouse and get some Patrick action on. We're gonna get fucking yes. I like how Mr. Krabs runs. It's like very frantic.
Still doing ketamine? What the fuck?
What the fuck is up with that head?
That new shit. Take a man's life.
Why would I take a man's life? That makes no fuck. Is this what actual ketamine does to you? Come on now. So yeah, we're just gonna be jumping. For some reason, bunny hopping seems to be the very ideal way of traversing this game. So yeah, you want to make sure the plankton guards do not get you, because that would be very bad if they did. Because once they gang up on you, you're pretty much fucked. So yeah, there's one Boy Scout. There's another Boy Scout. Come here, motherfucker. Here, fuck you. I will say that this game is very faithful to the Bikini Bottom setup and art style. It's very nice. Very nice touch. You can tell a lot of care and effort went into this game. Yep, I'm gonna punch him. We got one more motherfucker to kill. Or clobber to death with the claws. I'm punching him. Oh yeah. Now we gotta go back to Mr. Patrick. After grabbing some ketamine. Or not. Okay. Oh, but yeah, there's some ketamine. Now, this is the ketamine effect, baby. Oh, shit. Now we gotta go suck off Squidward, which I have no idea. How would you do sucking off a Squidward? Would you suck his nose? Or would he just grow another little penis tentacle out of his midsection there? Or would you have to fuck him in the belly button? I don't know. So yeah, we're just going to use our ketamine to kill the deer.
Hey, Mr. Krabs, I need you to sell these drugs to Sandy.
She's in town. Make sure you
get my money. Oh, God. Yeah, my computer does that whenever running this game. Makes Squidward's audio double for some reason. So, yeah, we're just gonna smash the fucking space bar out of this and just get over to Sandy, which is pretty much the final mission of the game, believe it or not. So, yeah, go back into town. Also, like, I don't know if it was put in Sandy's dialogue.
Oh, shit. Oh, no. What the fuck was that?
Do I like this game? Well, hell yeah, I do. Two thumbs up. Now we want to actually beat the game. Now, this glitch occurs whenever you talk to Squidward, and the camera's at a very straightforward angle. So yeah, we're going to be playing the rest of the game in first person, which is kind of nice, because we get to see a very rare view of Mr. Krabs. Just going to jolly hop our way over to the chummy chum cum bucket and kick some ass. So yeah, whenever you're in this area, you want to go left so you can grab the key, and then you're going to basically just turn around and go straight. I don't get why the seaweed is such a nuisance. I mean, very big hitbox. Now, I'm not really speedrunning here, as you can tell. A lot of people love speedrunning this game because of its broken nature, but I'm actually, you know, savoring the flavor, if you might as well, you know. So yeah, the game just ends. Now, we're gonna just dick around now. So yeah, for some reason, if you hold the jump button when you get near the end of the car, or on the side of the car for that matter, you hold down the space bar, you're just gonna fucking fly. So, some interesting results happen, as you can see. Yeah. So yeah, we're just gonna be fucking around. And oh yeah, if you tilt the camera too far down, you'll see just darkness, which is weird. Which is, I mean, I'm very glad this is all implemented very well into the game, so, you know, creates a more authentic Mr. Krabs on Ketamine experience. So now we're gonna be, finding a little Easter egg. Yeah. All I did was just go more for the side of the boat, so we're gonna run over here, and you're gonna see, I would assume, would be the developer of this game. Just nude, developing another game.
Can you give me a second? I'm too busy developing this game. I gotta develop this game. I can't talk right now. Come back later when you've got something for me.
So now you gotta find something after I climb this. Mr. Krabs has a very nice ass. I also find it very weird how this just keeps on going the more you hit space. I tried to ascend to the top of this anchor, but the game wasn't having it. Yep, there's the skybox. So straight ahead after Mr. Krabs stops hallucinating is the object of desire for this game developer. And I couldn't believe my fucking eyes because it's an Oculus Quest. I think, I don't know, it could just be a regular ass Oculus Rift. So you might be asking yourself, what is this used for? Well, if you take it back, the developer will give you something to help your progression through the game. So we're just gonna come up to him.
Finding my headset. Boom.
You
here,
just get the key.
Take this.
So that way, whenever you go into the chum bucket, you don't have to take that left. You can just go straight into Plankton's arena there and do the coin toss. So we're gonna fuck around a little bit more. Oh yeah, the front of the car kills you too if you try to grab it for some reason. So we're gonna go and break the shit out of this game. Yeah. Alright, just here we go. I'm ready to break this game. I'm gonna break the fuck out of it. You gotta stop making love to the boat, man. And now we're gonna be chasing the love. The love. The love boat. So why does this boat have these supernatural powers? I believe that because SpongeBob drives pretty much the same car in his driving school, that the more he fails, the more superpowered Neptune makes the car, so whenever Mr. Krabs uses it, it just has these beautiful effects. So I'm trying to break into the building, but it's not quite working out. So I figured, why not leave this place? As you can see, I successfully did it. We are now leaving Bikini Bottom forever. And when you're at this point, you cannot control Mr. Krabs on Ketamine. So we're just going to go beyond what the game is allowing us to see. And I want you, the viewer, to just savor this moment. Because this is a very genuine, handcrafted experience. Thank you to whoever developed this. Thank you to the speedrunning community. And again, thank you for watching this video. And make sure you like, comment, and subscribe if you want more of this jank-ass content. See ya.